all of you. In today's video lecture, we are going to learn what is the rheology. So, rheology is a branch of science which deals with the study of flow properties of liquid. So, what is the viscosity? So, we are going to learn the rheology in the term of viscosity. So, just let's get started. So, friends, in today's lecture, we are going to learn what is the rheology. So, what is the rheology? Rheology is a branch of science which deals with the study of flow properties of liquid and deformation of solid when there is shear stress applied on a particular solid. Okay, so what is the liquid? What is the rheology? Okay, so first we are going to discuss the classification of liquid. So there are the liquids are classified into mainly of two types. Okay, first is Newtonian liquid and second is non-Newtonian liquid. So, Newtonian liquid is liquid which obeys the Newton's law of flow, and in non-Newtonian liquid, the liquid which does not obey the Newton's law of flow. So, what is the Newton's law of flow? So, this equation represents the Newton's law of flow. Okay. So what is this equation? This equation explains that F is force, okay. F is equal to eta G, okay. So, eta is viscosity and G is, okay, surface free energy. Okay, so this is the equation. So, this equation explains the Newton's law of flow, Newtonian liquid, okay. So, in further, we are going to discuss the, if we draw a plot against a plot of shear stress against rate of shear, we will get a straight line in the case of Newtonian liquid, okay. So, and in the case of non-Newtonian liquid, they are further divided into three types, okay. First, they are subdivided into two types, okay, non-Newtonian liquid. First is time independent and second is time dependent, okay. So, in time independent, they are further classified into three types. First is plastic, second is pseudoplastic and third is dilatant flow. So, and in time dependent system, they are further classified into two types. First is thixotropic and second is negative thixotropic liquids. Okay. So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the Newtonian liquid. So just pause the video and take the screenshot. So what is the Newtonian liquid? Newtonian liquid which obeys the Newton's law of flow. Okay. So what is the Newton's law of flow? So this is the equation which represents the Newton's law of flow. So F is equal to eta G is the equation. So what is the F? F is the shearing stress. Okay. So whatever we apply the shear stress is F. Okay. What is the eta? Eta is viscosity of liquid. So viscosity of liquid, what is the viscosity? Viscosity of liquid is liquid resistance to flow is called as its viscosity. Okay. So at molecular level, if we apply a shear stress from here, then what happens at molecular level, from one molecule to the other molecule, the velocity of liquid is transferred from one molecule to other, okay, and because of the lower layer which is also covalently bond with upper layer, what happen? The upper layer get dragged by the lower layer. So in that case, the liquid which resistance to flow, okay, so that resistance is called as viscosity, okay, so it is a viscosity. So viscosity is represented with a eta. Okay, so this is the viscosity of liquid. And G is surface free energy, that means surface tension. Okay, then we are going to discuss a graphical representation of liquid at rest and liquid after shear stress. Okay, that means this is a hypothetical example. If consider this is a liquid and which having n number of layers of particles. Okay, this is just a hypothetical example. So our liquid have n number of layers in that total liquid. Okay, so at the rate the liquid is not moving, therefore that all the layers are lying on each other without any motion. So if we apply a shear stress on a layer, what will happen? It is behaves like a deck of card. Okay, what is the deck of card? If we touch the upper layer or if we apply a shear stress on a layer, what will happen? It get a particular velocity. Okay, a particular velocity. Then what will happen? It started moving. Okay, so because of that, it start because of dragging force between A and B. What will happen? B also starts moving, but the velocity of A layer is more than B. Okay, then why? Because B layer also dragged by C layer. On the same way, the velocity of B layer is relatively higher than C layer. Okay, so on the way that the last C and D also behave on the same way. So at the last layer on the surface is stationary in the Newtonian liquid. Okay, so this is the behavior of flow of liquid. Okay, so just pause the video and take the screenshot. Okay, so if we draw a plot against rate of shear and shearing stress, then what will we get? A straight line graph. We will get a straight line graph. Okay, so this graph represents that the rate of shear is directly proportional to the viscosity of liquid. Okay, so in that case, the example of that liquids are water, alcohol, that kind of liquid behaves like a Newtonian liquid. Okay, so just pause the video and take the screenshot. So non-Newtonian liquid are further classified into three types. First is plastic flow or plastic liquids, liquid flow. Okay, pseudoplastic flow, and third is dilatant flow. So there are several examples of that kind of liquid. Okay, so in the first plastic liquid flow, there are presence of flocculated particles in that kind of liquid. Okay, so if we draw a graph, so we will get a graph which is not oriented from the origin. Why? Because in the plastic liquid flow, if we apply a shear stress at the beginning, so plastic liquid flow and pseudoplastic liquid flow. So what is the difference between plastic and pseudoplastic flow? So in the case of plastic liquid, if we draw a graph against shearing stress and rate of shear, we will get a graph which is starts from the orientation in the case of pseudoplastic flow. But in the case of plastic flow, the graph does not start from the orientation. For example, I will just draw the graph. Okay, so just wait. Okay, so G is shearing stress. Okay, rate of shear. This is G is rate of shear and this is shearing stress. Okay, F is shearing stress and rate of shear. So we will get a graph. In that graph, what will happen if we draw a graph against rate of shear and shearing stress? We will get a graph which does not start from orientation in the case of plastic liquid. Okay, so maybe it starts from any point on a x-axis. Okay, so we will start that graph if we apply a shear stress. Okay, so that liquid having flocculated particles. Okay, what is the flocculated particles? Flocculated particles means they have loose aggregates. Okay, they are arranged with each other as a loose aggregate. Okay, so they are bounded with each other. Okay, so this is the flocculus. Okay, so what happens if we apply a shear stress? Okay, that means force. Okay, if we apply a shear stress on that kind of liquid, what will happen at the initial stage? That because of a cohesive force between that particles, they get stretched. Okay, the particle gets stretched okay, but they does not follow any kind of flow. Okay, unless we apply a shear stress beyond yield value. Okay, what is the yield value? For example, if we apply a shear stress on plastic liquid flow, okay, plastic liquid type, what will happen at the initial stage? It does not show any flow, but whenever they start flowing, if we withdraw the shear stress, what will happen? It returns to their original consistency. Okay, so this is a yield value Y, which is denoted by Y. Okay, so if we apply a force beyond that yield value, it will starts behaving like a Newtonian liquid after yield value. Okay, so this is the mechanism of plastic flow. And in the case of pseudoplastic flow, there are, if we draw a plot rate of shear against shearing stress. Okay, so this is shearing stress and this is a rate of shear. Okay, so if we draw a graph in the case of pseudoplastic flow, okay, so in the case of pseudoplastic flow, the graph starts from the beginning. Okay, so we will get a graph in such a way. So we cannot get a linear graph. Okay, so after a while, the flow is gradually increased in the case of pseudoplastic flow. Okay, so this is two graphs. For first graph is for plastic flow and second is for pseudoplastic flow. So in the case of plastic flow, the graph does not start from orientation. This is the orientation. Okay, so in the case of pseudoplastic flow, graph starts from beginning, from orientation. That means whenever we apply a shear stress, it starts flowing in the case of pseudoplastic flow. But in the case of plastic flow, it does not flow at the beginning. Okay, so after that we are going to learn what is the dilatant flow. So just pause the video and take the screenshot. Okay, so in non-Newtonian liquid, it is a dilatant type flow. In the dilatant type flow, there is presence of more than 55% of deflocculated particles. Okay, that means the concentration of deflocculated particles in that dispersion is higher. Okay, so what is the mechanism of deflocculated dilatant flow? So consider this is a system, okay, having a deflocculated particles, okay, cornstarch particle having concentration more than 55%. So deflocculated particles, okay, crystals means deflocculated particles in dilatant flow, okay, so the concentration of that crystal C is more than 55% in our system. That means the concentration of liquid is lesser in that system. So the crystals are all over in that jar, okay, or in that any container. Okay, so the crystals are all over in that system and the liquid is in between that crystals. Okay, so this is the liquid which is entrapped in between that crystals. Okay, so if we apply a shear stress, in that case what will happen if we hammer the surface of that liquid, what will happen? Okay, so at the surface of hitting, the liquid get, okay, just liquid escape from that region, okay, so just go towards other direction, okay, just escape from that region and move towards the other region, okay, so what will happen? It will create a void, okay, at that place. So at that place that system behaves like solid, okay, so this is called as a dilatant flow. That means whenever we apply a shear stress, the viscosity of liquid get increased, therefore we call that system a shear thickening system, okay. After applying a shear stress, the thickness of liquid is get increased. Okay, so just pause the video and take the screenshot. So this is the end of today's video. If you like today's video, please hit the like button. And if you are new on my channel, you can watch my previous video by clicking on I button. And please subscribe my channel. Thanks.